Hi, welcome to Chef Maxwell's Kitchen. We're here at the Farm Bureau and we're going to play with some Virginia food. This time a real classic Virginia food. We're talking about apples, and apples are part of Virginia's identity. We're representing the Department of Agriculture for the Commonwealth of Virginia and their Virginia Grown program, which wants you to know how to tell what's really good in a grocery store is to look for the Made in Virginia label. All right, like I said, we're going to be doing apples and we're going to make a classic apple pie, but we're going to do it a little bit different, make it a little bit easier on you. And this is a classically flavored apple pie. And we're going to put two kinds of sugar in here. We're going to put brown sugar, and we're going to put white sugar. We're going to put a little bit of white flour. Right. We're going to put some nutmeg, and the recipe will be up in a minute and let you know how much of all of these things to put in there. We're going to put a little bit of cinnamon. All right, a little bit of lemon zest. Now you can either take this off a fresh lemon, or you can buy zest in the grocery store. Peel. We're going to put that in there, and we're going to mix this all up. All right, mix this all up so that all the ingredients are mixed together. You can tell that pretty much because the brown colors from the nutmeg and the cinnamon will go all the way through it, and that kind of lets you know it's mixed up. All right, now we're going to take our apples, and we've washed them off good. Even though they're Virginia apples, you want to wash your products before you start to work with them. All right, and we're going to cut them. Here's a good way to cut them. I'm not going to peel these. I like peels in here. All right, and we're going to cut nice thin slices. We didn't have to have a separate core, you see. I just trimmed away from the edge. We're going to throw them in here. And once they're in here, be careful, I don't want to cut myself on my knife. These are delicious looking apples. And in there they go. Once we get this filled with the sliced apples, we're going to add some raisins. And we're going to toss this up. And since I know you don't want to sit here and watch me slice apples, we're going to slice the rest of the apples and we'll be right back to make the pie. All right, we're back. As you can see, I've got all of the apples in here, sliced, mixed with the raisins and the seasonings, and we're all set and ready to go. Now, one of the hardest things about making a pie is making the pie crust, so I'm going to show you how to do it really easy. Buy it. What I've done here is I bought a pie crust. It came in this pan. It was lined here. I took it out. I rolled it out some more. All right. And I'm going to try and get it up here. Fold it over. All right. Now, when you do this, the apples are going to go in. I'm making a one crust pie. It's just going to be on the top. So the apples will go in here. But to keep them from sticking to the bottom, we're going to spray it a little bit. All right. Now we're going to fill it up with our apple mixture. Right, we want to really overfill it. You want to just pile it on up. Right, because these apples are fresh, we haven't cooked them down at all, and they're going to shrink a little bit as they give off the liquid. Right. We have a little bit of flour in that mix to help tighten it up. Now, we've got our crust goes on. Right. And just in case you're not a grandma, this is going to look like a grandma made it. Right. We're going to wrinkle it up just a little bit on the edges. Right. And then press it with our fingers. You can use a fork on this. Right. And just press it down onto the edge of the pie tin. And take the back of your knife. Take that off. Now, because there's a lot of moisture in the apples, they're going to create some steam, so we want to cut some steam vents. Just cut a couple of slices in here, all right, so that the steam can get out without making the pie explode. All right. Now, we're going to brush this with a little bit of butter, just a little bit of melted butter, and we're going to brush it with a little bit of egg. And that'll help it brown off really, really nice. And I'm going to step off camera as I put this in the oven. And you see how quick that is? Actually, we had this one baked a little bit, and you can actually see where the crust has fallen in as the apples have shrunk. So we're all set here. I'm going to get a plate. We're going to put this on a plate and see what it looks like inside. But this is a delicious and quick apple pie. It takes about 40 minutes at 325 degrees, and it's going to brown up really nice, and it smells incredible while it cooks. All right, and here we've got it. We've got a one crust apple pie made with good Virginia apples. The top crust makes it eat almost like a cobbler. It's delicious. It's a screaming for a good scoop of vanilla ice cream. Once again, we've proved that as long as it's Virginia grown, it's okay to play with your food. We'll see you next time. This recipe and all the recipes we've had here at Chef Maxwell's Kitchen are available on Recipes from Chef Maxwell's Kitchen, 10 Years of Tasty Television. Our new cookbook is coming out very soon, so make sure you visit the website and check on that. For more delicious recipes using Virginia-grown fruits and vegetables, contact Lisa Lloyd at the Virginia Department of Agriculture, 1100 Bank Street, Richmond, Virginia, 23219.
Chef Maxwell's recipes are available on the Virginia Farm Bureau website at www.vafb.com.